But waking the patient up is a specific thing. So I've got some information up on the ABCs of Anaesthesia Facebook group, but and in the workbook. But essentially, this is the structure that I want you guys to have. The aim is physiologically stable with good analgesia. They need to be obeying commands and return on muscle function. And so I've got this system of, are they safe? Are the ABCs normal? I do some safety steps, and then I reverse the triad and reversing the hypnotic and muscle relaxant, but still keeping the analgesia roughly there. So step-by-step sequence, I ask the question, are the ABCs stable? Are the sats reasonable on a normal FiO2 with minimal PEEP? So most times you'll run a case at 50% FI, the sats not below something crazy with minimal pressure support or PEEP to have achieved good ventilation. You'll know what that means when the time comes. So I've got good tidal volumes with normal pressures, heart rate and BP in the normal range for the patient, not requiring large doses of aramine or inotropes to maintain the blood pressure. The surgical blood results have been treated with volume of blood, analgesia is adequate, and then I do this. I insert the bite block, increase my FI. So now I've got lots of oxygen in the lungs just in case something happens. So it's like pre-oxygenation, but for the extubation instead of the intubation. I suction the airway so there's no gunk that could be inhaled down into the trachea and the lungs. And then I position the patient, you know, head up so that they've got the best mechanical advantage for extubation. I check my equipment, and then I do this to reverse the triad. Turn off the volatile, put all the flows up. When they start, you'll get a feel for the different ventilation modes, so don't worry too much about that. But as they start breathing up, you can then switch to a different mode. You can reverse muscle relaxation with neostigmine and glyco or sugammadex if it's particularly rocuronium or vecuronium. I then check the return of muscle function, ask, can you squeeze my hand, open your eyes, take a deep breath in, and make sure that these are all good. When the patient inhales, I remove the endotracheal tube immediately, and then I assess everything again to make sure the ABCs are fine. Again, this is practical stuff, and the whole point of this session is really I just want to give you frameworks because a lot of this is going to be, you know, on the day learning how to do this stuff. But without the framework, you can't really get your consultant to give you the rope to train on this early on.